Welcome to Lecture 5.3, Applications of Differential Calculus, Rate of Change. Recall that the slope of a line tells us the rate of change of y with respect to x. Suppose we have here y is equal to 2x plus 4. Then the derivative of y with respect to x is equal to 2, and the slope of the line is equal to 2. We have here the following table of values for y is equal to 2x plus 4. Here we have an increasing values of x for one unit, and then we have the following values for y. Now, what do we notice about the differences between the values of y? So here we have 2, and then 2, and another 2. As the value of x increases by 1, it follows that the value of y when x is equal to 1 is equal to 6. And then 8, 10. Why is that? Because the rate of change of y for every 1 unit of x is equal to 2. That is the derivative. What is the interpretation? For every 1 unit increase in x, there is 2 unit increase in y. So that is the rate of change. The rate of change tells us how much a variable changes with respect to another variable that is also changing. Given a square of side s, how fast does its area A change as s changes? Symbolically, what is the derivative of A with respect to S? What is the derivative of the area with respect to the side? Take note that the side here is variable. When you say variable, it is changing. Whether increasing or decreasing, it is a variable. Now, when you say variable, this is not the same as constant. Okay, when we say constant, the value is fixed. But if it is a variable, its value changes. Example 1. A square has a variable side s and is lengthening. Find how much its area A and perimeter P are changing with respect to s. All right, so let us have the same drawing, the same illustration here. Okay, for the area, the area of a square is defined by the formula S squared. Since we are asked to find the rate of change of area with respect to the side, we are going to get the derivative of the area with respect to S, and that is 2S. And then we will have the following unit. We have 2S squared unit per unit. So take note that it means that for every 1 unit increase in the side, there is 2s squared units increase in the area. Next, let's have the P perimeter. So we are asked to find the rate of change of the perimeter with respect to the side. The perimeter of a square is 4 times s. Now, getting the derivative of perimeter with respect to S, we have 4. What is the unit for this derivative? We have 4 unit per unit. Meaning to say, for every 1 unit increase in the side, there is a corresponding 4 unit increase in the perimeter. So this is now the answer. Example 2. The base of a right triangle is 25 centimeters and the altitude is y. Find the rate of change of the hypotenuse area and perimeter with respect to the altitude. First, let us draw the triangle. It is a right triangle, so let's draw that square at the right angle. The base is 25 centimeters and then the altitude is y. So take note that when we have something like this, the base of a right triangle is 25. This one means that the base is constant. Okay. And when we say the altitude is y, it is variable. So This triangle can still lengthen like this. All right, so for the hypotenuse C, C is equal to the square root of, using the Pythagorean, we have here y squared plus 625. Now, we are tasked to find the rate of change, so we are going to get the derivative of the hypotenuse with respect to y. Okay, so what is the derivative of this? We will make use of the derivative of square root. On the denominator, you have 2 and then square root of y squared plus 625. And then on the numerator, we have the derivative of something that is inside the square root. That is 2y. Okay, so this will cancel out. So this is now our answer. Y over the square root of y squared plus 625. And for the unit, we have centimeter per centimeter. So meaning to say, for every 1 unit increase in the altitude, we have y over the square root of y squared plus 625 centimeter increase in the hypotenuse. Okay, next, let's have the area. The area of a triangle is 1/2 base times height. So we have 1/2, and then the base is 25, and the height is y. So getting the rate of change of the area with respect to the altitude, we have 25 over 2. That is the answer. And then don't forget the unit. The unit for the area is square centimeter, and for the altitude, we have centimeter. So the interpretation of this one, for every 1 unit increase in the altitude, there's a corresponding 25 over 2 square centimeter increase in the area. Next, for C, the perimeter. The perimeter of the triangle is simply the sum of all the sides. The perimeter is equal to 25 plus y, and then plus the hypotenuse, we have y squared plus 625. Getting the rate of change of this, we have 1 plus, and then for the hypotenuse, this is the same as the letter A. So we have y over the square root of y squared plus 625. Since this is perimeter, the unit for perimeter is just centimeter. And then we have per centimeter. Next, example 3, the minor axis of an ellipse remains fixed at 10 units while its major axis x lengthens. Find the rate of change of its area with respect to the major axis. Okay, let's draw an ellipse here. So the area for ellipse is this. A is equal to pi times AB, where A and B are the semi-major, and B is semi-minor. Okay, the minor axis is 10 units, and then the major axis is X. It says here that the major axis is lengthening, so meaning to say the entire ellipse is actually shrinking or getting longer, just like this one, while the minor axis remains the same. Now, something like that. All right, let us have the formula for the area given the following. We are asked to find the derivative of the area with respect to the major axis. So how will we tweak this formula? Okay, we have pi, and then for the A, the semi-major axis, since it is half of the major, so we have x over 2. And then for the small b, the minor axis, and then for the small b, the semi-minor axis, that is equal to 5, half of 10. So here we will have 5 over 2 pi x. This is now very easy. The derivative of the area with respect to the major axis is equal to 5 over 2 pi. And then we have squared units per unit. So meaning to say, for every 1 unit increase in the major axis, there's a corresponding 5 over 2 pi squared units increase in the area. Example 4. Water is being poured in a cistern in the shape of right circular cylinder with base radius 50 centimeters. Find the rate of change of its volume V with respect to the increasing altitude. Okay, suppose that water is being poured here, so meaning to say the altitude is increasing. All right. The radius of the base remains 50 centimeters. It is fixed. Of course. Hindi naman pwedeng lumaki yung tangke. Okay, next. What are you going to do? The volume of the right circular cylinder is pi r squared h. Okay. We have here a fixed value for the radius. We have here the volume is equal to pi times 50 squared, and then your h, this is the h. It is increasing because water is being poured. Well, this is the limit. But we're talking about the water. Okay, simplifying this further, we have 2,500 pi h. Now, getting the rate of change of the volume with respect to the height, the answer is 2,500 pi cubic centimeter per centimeter. So for every 1 centimeter increase in the water, there is a corresponding 2,500 pi cubic centimeter increase in the volume. So this is the answer. You have now reached the end of the lecture 5.3. You are highly encouraged to answer the following exercise.